Well, tonight I'm working on the old Ico 324. And I got my parts in last week, and I'm changing all of these old caps. Now, I do have the old cap tester out, and we are gonna test them all for giggles, since everybody seems to like to be doing that now. So, get this big old industrial cord plugged in here with the fold away ground. How do you like that? Alright, so the first one I cut out. This is, by the way, this is 1959. This was originally built. This is a York Electronics. Alright, so we got the cap hooked up. You know, this one is not excessively leaky or out of range. Is that going to be too bright? I don't know how good that's going to come out. But okay, you see how sharp that is? Now watch when we start applying voltage to it. Boy, it gets fuzzy. And that's 200 volts. Not too leaky. Potted up to 400. Full working voltage. Look how fuzzy that eye has gotten. And then we check the leakage. That's enough, but you can see. I mean, this was... That'll be good for a guitar amp. So far, this has been the only cap that tested good out of the whole thing. This is a Pyramid Imp plastic case cap. Yes, this thing would work better if I plugged it in a receptacle here. There she comes. This is supposed to be a 0.05, and I mean, she's reading 0.0534, and as we crank the voltage up, it's a 400 volt cap. I'm just going to go all the way to 400. And we can see no leakage whatsoever. None whatsoever. And this even looks pretty good. This old Pyramid two-section electrolytic, I can't even get it to give a reading on the meter anymore anywhere on either section. And needless to say, it's leaky. There's 60, 70 volts. It's at 100. Yeah. Goes in the garbage. This one here I tested. Come on, camera. Alright, the next one. Look how fuzzy that is. It's zero. Let's see. Put the voltage on. Let's give her 200 volts. That's about 220. Boop. Oh yeah, look at her leak. Let's pot it on up. Let's give it a works. Peg the meter. Look at that. So that's why. I understand why people want to check all of this stuff. If you're just diagnosing something, that's fine. But I mean, I want this thing to work. You know, I'm going to use this thing. And I mean, I'm doing this out of curiosity. But I mean, let's face it, you know. I mean, this is garbage in here. This is garbage. So I'll get through the rest of them. I already put the one over here to replace that first one. Got some resistors down here that ain't worth a darn, so we'll be replacing those too. But alrighty, I'll be back. This one here, I tested, and no good either. A Gutermann. Here's all the rest. York. These are all York branded. And then we had this one from earlier, another Gutermann. So out of all the electrolytics in here, the only one good was that little pyramid cap that was the line cap. So now I'm going to have to figure out what I'm going to do. Let's see. Well, finished doing everything to the 324, and the only thing I got left to do is to finish the connector here. I took it out because I'm going to take it to Radio Shack with me to try to find something that I can make work on the end of this little plug. And working on everything but band B, which of course is the one you'd really be using, 400 kilocycles to 1.2 megacycles. Every band is working but band B. So I did some poking around, and it turns out that this is the coil. It's open. Now, let me get my magnifying glass. Let's see, where in the heck did I put it around here? I'm gonna get my magnifying glass so I can show you the just hit it. I wanna show you the coil, the wire. I seen how it broke. I peeled you let the insulation back. And oh shit, there it is. Alright, let's see. And there we can see the broken wires going into the coil. That little piece of string you see there, that's where they fed in originally. Alright, turn her on and give you a quick demo.
In the day when she was younger, the dress was appropriate.
Of course, this needs to be calibrated. But
nevertheless, it looks good. And also, I also want to ask you about.
Yeah, but you're the women or an older guy who likes younger women.
Radio, he couldn't compete with me.
So, of course, B band is dead.
From a wooden tooth, okay, I understand that. You have to do it from the plaque.
Pick up the harmonics.
Okay. It's the Savage Nation.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE. 855-400-7282. Savage.
Hey, you think
think your money in the bank is safe? Don't bank on it. A generation ago, bank accounts felt secure, and they paid interest. This encouraged the virtue of thrift and saving, building a prosperous America of opportunity. But today, we live in a new world order.
Real clean right there. Reading more like 96. Yep. So, time to do something about that coil.